Hey, it's Andrew. Today we're taking a look at one of JetForm Builder's most anticipated features, recurring Stripe payments. This brand new add-on lets you connect your forms directly to Stripe, set up one-time or recurring payments, and even link them to user registration, all from inside WordPress. I'll walk you through the full setup, from creating a Stripe product and building a two-step subscription workflow to showing or hiding premium content for paying users. I'll also show you how to automatically restrict user access once the subscription expires or is cancelled. It's a small setup and a game changer for anyone running memberships or paid content sites. Let's jump in. First, let's set up our Stripe account and create a subscription product we'll connect to JetForm Builder later. I'm using Stripe in sandbox mode, which means we can test the full payment flow without making real transactions. If you don't have an account yet, go to stripe.com, sign up and log in. Once you're inside, you'll see the main dashboard. In the top right corner, there's a toggle that lets you switch between test and live modes whenever you're ready. Next, open the Product Catalog tab and click Create Product. Here I'll name it VIP Job Listings Monthly, since that is what our users will be subscribing to. We can also add a short description or an image. Set the pricing model to recurring, enter the amount, and choose the billing period. Once you hit Add Product, Stripe will create the plan and display it in the product catalog list. Now open Developers API keys in the Stripe dashboard. Copy the publishable key and the secret key. We'll paste them into WordPress in just a moment. Go to WordPress and go to JetForm Builder add-ons. If you haven't activated the Stripe Payment Gateway add-on yet, install and activate it now. Next, open JetForm Builder, Settings, Payments Gateways. Toggle Enable Gateways. If you're testing, also enable Test Mode. Paste the publishable key and secret key you copied from Stripe and click Save. Done! Your site is now linked to Stripe and sandbox payments will run exactly like real ones, just without charging a card. Now we will build two forms for the setup, one to register the user and another to lead to the Stripe payment page. The second form will appear right after the first one is submitted. Go to JetForm Builder, add new and start from scratch. I'll name the form Registration Form. Let's add the basic fields first, name, email and password. The information filled in these fields will be used for creating user profiles. You can change the default action button label to something like register. Now let's set up what happens after the user submits the form. Open the Post Submit Actions tab. Ensure that the Save Form Record action is added. It allows storing all form submissions inside the WordPress dashboard. Next, click plus new action and add another action, register user. We'll use it to automatically create an account for users who submit the form. In the edit register user pop-up, map your form fields to the corresponding user meta fields which are required. Then set the user role to contributor and enable the toggle that says login user after register. This way, users will be automatically logged in after form submission and will not need to log in separately. The user will be assigned one of the default WordPress roles, to which I'll add no premium content features. That's it for register user details, so hit update. Then click the Edit Conditions and Events button next to the Register User label to open a pop-up with settings. Under the Events Match tab, select Default Process from the drop-down. This ensures that the user registration happens after the form submits successfully. Now we can publish the form. Let's create the second form and name it Subscription Form. Inside, add a checkbox field confirming that the user wants to start the subscription. a hidden field that stores the current user ID, and a submit button. Let's call it subscribe. Now in the form settings dashboard, scroll down to the gateway settings section. Enable Stripe checkout and click edit to open the settings pop-up. Here, turn on use global settings so the form inherits the Stripe keys we added earlier. In the gateway action dropdown, select subscription. This tells JetForm Builder to connect to a recurring payment product you already created in Stripe. If we choose Pay Now instead, we'd have to define the price directly inside this form. Under Subscription Plan, choose Manual Input, then pick the plan we created in Stripe. Hit Refresh Plans from Stripe if you just created the product in Stripe and it's not in the list yet. Finally, click Update. Go to Post Submit Actions and add an Update User action. In the pop-up for the action settings, link the hidden user ID field to the user ID parameter and change the user role to subscriber. Then open the actions, conditions and events pop-up and under events match select gateway success. So the role update happens only after Stripe confirms the payment. We'll also create another update user action that works when the subscription is cancelled. In this action settings, set the role to contributor, the role that sees non-premium content. In the actions events, add Stripe subscription cancelled. You can also attach other downgrade events, such as subscription expired when Stripe doesn't receive the payment, or subscription suspended. Configure anyone or all of these events to trigger the action. Once you've done that, click Update and then publish the form. Now that the forms that register and log new users and connect them to Stripe payments are done, let's see what kind of content paying users will get access to. Of course, there are many ways to offer premium content. For example, by showing more detailed data on posts, adjusting the visibility of specific meta fields, or even blocking access to certain pages. On my website, I'll keep it simple and show more job ads to premium users. In this example, I have a custom post type called Jobs. Each job post includes a custom radio field called Premium with two options, yes and no. This field will control which listings are visible to subscribers. Next, let's open the listing template for the jobs post type. I've added a small premium badge inside the card layout so users can easily see which ads are exclusive. To make that badge appear only on premium posts, we'll use dynamic visibility, a jet engine feature that I'll be using several more times in this tutorial. Note that that feature requires activating one of the default Jet Engines modules. Select the badge widget, in my case it's a heading, then go to the advanced settings. Unroll the dynamic visibility section and enable the toggle. For the visibility condition type, choose show element if condition met. Under conditions, select equal, then indicate the post's custom field, premium. For the value that the field will be checked against, type yes. This condition makes the badge appear only on posts where the premium field is set to yes. Now I'll use this template to create two listings on the homepage, both showing job posts but with different visibility rules. Premium users will see the version that also includes the listings with badges, and we'll control that difference using a custom query applied to one of the grids. To create that query, go to Jet Engine, Query Builder, Add New, and name it Not Premium Content. Set the query type to Post and select Jobs as the post type. Scroll down to Meta Query and add a new item where the field key is Premium, the name of Jet Engine Meta field. set the compare operator to equal and the value to no. This way, the query will only return job posts that are not premium. While we're here, I'll also limit the number of posts per page to 6. Once a query is applied to a listing grid, its settings override the widget or block settings, so this is the right place to control how many posts are shown. Click Update to save the query. Now let's go to the homepage, where I have two identical sections, each with a header and a listing grid showing the job's post type, both with Load More functionality enabled and their own dedicated buttons. I'll apply the Not Premium Content query to just one of these grids. The other one stays unfiltered, showing all jobs, including the premium ones. Now we need to decide which listing each user will see based on user roles. For this, we'll use conditional visibility on the elements that hold our listing grids. Let's start with the non-premium content one. Open the widget settings, go to dynamic visibility and enable it. Then set the condition to hide element if user role is subscriber. This way, once a user pays through our subscription form, the regular listings will disappear from view. For the second grid, also enable dynamic visibility, but this time set it to show element if user role is subscriber. That's all it takes to separate what free and paying users see. Before we test everything, let's make this page feel like a real use case. Right above the listings, I'll place both forms that we created earlier. Then I'll set their dynamic visibility to hide them under different conditions. I'll make registration form visible only to non-logged-in users, and subscription form visible only to users with the contributor role. In this setup, we don't even need a separate login form. Remember, when we configured the register user action, we enabled the toggle login user after register. That means every new user is automatically logged in right after completing the registration form. And I will personalize the experience with the headings. I'll add one above each listing and they will follow the same visibility rules as the grids and widgets that contain them. For premium users, I'll use a heading widget where for an input I'll use a dynamic tag that outputs the currently logged in user's nickname, and add a static text around it to make it something like Enjoy Premium Ads username. And for those who registered but didn't pay, I'll make a heading that says Hey username, would you like to subscribe for premium content? Now is the moment of truth. Let's test how everything works on the front end. First, I log out of the site to see the page as a new visitor. Right away, we can see the registration form and the listing grid showing only regular, non-premium job posts. Let's register a new user. After submitting the form, we stay on the same page, and now the subscription form appears with a friendly greeting and an offer to subscribe. The grid still shows non-premium content since we're currently logged in as contributor. Now I'll check the checkbox and submit the subscription form. The form redirects us to Stripe checkout page where I can complete the payment. After the payment is confirmed, Stripe sends us back to the site and everything updates automatically. The registration form disappears and we're now greeted with the premium listings, visible only to subscribers. If we check the backend under JetForm Builder Payments, we can see a new payment record. And in JetForm Builder Subscriptions, there's a new entry showing the user's active subscription. From here, the site admin can cancel or suspend the subscription with one click or open it to view all the details. Let's also open the Stripe dashboard and find the subscription section. Here we can see the same subscription added automatically with the customer's details, amount, and billing period. Everything is neatly synchronized between Stripe and JetForm Builder. If we check the new user profile in WordPress, we'll see that their role is subscriber, exactly as planned. Now remember that we created an action to handle canceled subscriptions. Let's test that. I'll open JetForm Builder subscriptions, cancel the active one, and then log in again as that user. Now the premium listings disappear and we see the message inviting us to subscribe. In the backend, the user's role is back to contributor. And that's it. We've just built a complete payment and access system using JetForm Builder, Jet Engine, and Stripe. This new JetForm Builder add-on helps you easily handle both recurring and one-time payments and manage subscriptions right from the WordPress dashboard, whether it's for memberships, online courses, or donations. If you found this tutorial helpful, give it a like, subscribe, and let us know in the comments how you plan to use Stripe payments on your own site. Thanks for watching and see you in the next Rockoblock tutorial.